पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमोहम सुख नित्यम सुप्रकाश व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धे परम सर्वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहं नमत्तो मे निश्चिता मति ही हिरण्यगर्भ लोकवासिनः असंग निर्विकार ब्रह्मरूपतया आत्मनः भाने कारणम्। How does one become one with Hiranyagarbha? So, being in Hiranyagarbha Loka, Brahma Loka, how does that help a person become one with Nirguna Brahma? So, that is the question there. Nirvikara Brahma is Nirguna Brahma. So, Nirguna Brahma Rupataya Atmanaha Bhane Karanam Kim? For those who have attained Brahmaloka. Because jnanena moksha, just by attaining Brahmaloka, there cannot be moksha. So how that jnana takes place has to be mentioned. Therefore, this 314th avarta says, Purvam omkarasya brahma rupataya upasana kale omkara matrana arthaha vakshamana ritya chintitaha. So, a brief summary is given of how the vichara was done when the person was an upasaka. Nirguna Brahma upasaka, ahangraha upasaka. He had seen Omkara as Brahma and then that Brahma as oneself. This is how his upasana was. So, stula upadhi vishishta viradatmaka vishvachaitanya makara rupa prathama matraya vachyartha. How was this aikya possible? Aikya jnanotpatti in Brahmaloka, how is it possible? Because earlier, samskaras are there. When were these samskaras created? When he was doing upasana as a manushya. What was his samskara based on? The dhyana. What kind of dhyana? That is mentioned here as makara rupa. Omkara's makara is what stula upadhi vishishta viradatmaka vishwa chaitanya makara. Chaitanyam, sorry, Vishwa Chaitanyam Akara Rupa Prathama Matraya Vachyartha, not Makara, Akara. So it's not a samasa. So stula, first is Akara, then Ukara, Makara. So stula, we have seen this is a summary. So anyway, Vachyartha and Laksharatha differentiation we had not made. So that is shown here that Akara is a Vachyartha, Ukara is a Vachyartha, Makara is a Vachyartha. Pamatra is the real goal. Turiyatma, which is in the individual and total level, there is no difference, which is the same, which is not similar, which is same in, at the individual and total level. So, stula upadhi vishishta viradatmaka, vishwa. So, vishwa is not one with virat. Virat has become one with vishwa at the vyashti level. That vishwa chaitanya is akara rupa, omkara zakara. Who has taken the individual stula upadhi, but not stula upadhi individually, because other individuals will remain. Therefore, Virat is considered who has all the stula upadhis, including the upasaka stula upadhi. Therefore, that stula samashti. So, this stula is what? Samashti stula upadhi vishishta Virat atmaka vishwaha. Atmaka, atma is here swabhava, sarupa. So, stula upadhi vishishta Virat atmaka yaha vishwaha. That Vishwa is not without Chaitanya. Vishwa is not Jada Sharira. Jada Sharira Abhimani. So, Stula Vyashti Stula Sharira Abhimani. Vyashti Stula Jada Sharira Abhimani Chaitanya. That Chaitanya is Akara Rupa. Which is, happens to be Pratham Matra of Omkara. And that is the Vachyartha. It is the primary meaning or literal meaning. Then, Sukshma Upadhi Vishishta Hiranyagarbhatmaka Taijasa Chaitanyam. Ukara Rupa Dvitiya Matraya Vachyartha. And further, it is merged, this Virat, who is Vishwa, that Vishwa is merged in Tejasa. Who is that Tejasa? Tejasa is Hiranyagarbhatmaka. So Samashti Stula Sharira Abhimani. Therefore, Samashti Sukshma Upadi Vishishta Hiranyagarbhatmaka Tejasa Chaitanya. Again, Sukshma Sharira is Jada without the Chaitanya. So that Chaitanya, which is identified, has Tadatmya Sambandha with the Sukshma Sharira, which is one with the Samashti Sukshma Sharira Abhimani Hiranyagarbha, that is Ukara. And what kind of Ukara? This Dvitiya Matra of Omkara, not any other Ukara. Omkara Ukara. Elsewhere, Omkara is also specified. In, I think, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, the first chapter itself, there, which kind of Omkara? It cannot be any Omkara. It has to be a particular Omkara of Sama. Even in Sama, in particular Uccharana, Omkara is pronounced, that Upasana should be done. So it is very specific on how it has to be done. Here in Ahangra, we know that the sannyasi sees this as oneself. But it is the literal meaning. This Ukara is the literal meaning there, but we have to go to the implied meaning. Karanopadi Vishishte Ishwaratmaka Prajna Chaitanyam. This should be Makara. So there is a typo here. So Makara Rupa Tritiya Matraya Vachyartha. So this is not Ukara, this should be Makara Rupa. Akara Ukara Makara. So Karana Upadi is the Karana Sharira. Samashti Karana Sharira is the Upadi, which is what Samashti Karana Sharira is, Maya. So Maya is the Upadi of Ishvara. Therefore, Karana Upadi Vishishta Ishvara Atmaka Prajna. And that happens to be Prajna Sushupti Avastha Abhimani at the Vyashti level. That Prajna Chaitanya, again, Avidya is Jada. Avidya or Karana Sharira is Jada. Chaitanya, which reflects in that, the original Chaitanya, that is limited by the individual Avidya, and therefore segmented as reflected consciousness. And that Abhimani happens to be one with Makara in the Dhyana. Which Makara? Omkara Makara again. So Omkara Makara Rupa Tritiya Matraya Vachyartha. Evam Prak Chintitartha Anusmaranam Upasakasya Brahmaloke Jayate. This is exactly what is born. This vritti takes place in the antakarana of the Upasaka in Brahmaloka. Sattva Guna Prabhavacha Vakshamana Prakarana Viveka Purvaka Vicharati Cha Upasakaha. Then this Upasaka in Brahmaloka, who has got Brahmaloka as his phala, in him Sattva Guna is Sanjata. The most predominant is Sattva Guna. There is hardly any Tamas and Rajoguna. So Tamas and Rajas being less, Sattva Guna Prabhavat, what happens? Vakshamana Prakarana Viveka Purvam Vicharayati Cha Upasaka. Upasaka thinks in this manner now. Gathering the Vachyartha of the Upasana that he has done earlier. Stula Upadhi Drishtya Khalu Shuddhe Chaitanya Virattva Vishvattva Pratiti Rabhut Tatra Samashti Stula Drishtya Virattvam Vyashti Stula Drishtya Vishvattvam Cha Vahat. So he knows now that the perspective is changing now. Earlier, the Abhimana with the Stula Sharira, Sukshma Sharira was so much in the Manushya Sharira because the Upadhi is such where Rajoguna and Tamoguna keep on influencing so much that Sattva is rarely there. During the Upasana also, the commitment to follow the way the Shruti has said is so much, and to avoid the Rajoguna Karya, Tamoguna Karya to drag away the person is so much that a person is not able to do complete vichara. If he is able to do vichara, then he wouldn't have come to Brahmaloka. He would have got moksha there itself as Jivan Mukti would have been the phala. But that shows that obstacles were a lot. He was not able to understand clearly. Now this Atma Anatma Bheda is so clear in Brahmaloka that he is able to think this. He is able to look at the analysis from the perspective. From the Stula Upadhi Drishti, Shuddhe Chaitanya Virattva Vishvattva Pratiti Rabhut. It is a Pratiti Matra. Samashti and Vyashti Bhedas are Pratiti Matras. at the stool and sukshma levels both. So samashti vyashtyatmaka stula drishti virahe virartha vishyatvana pratiyatam. So if you take away the upadhis, which is what is taught here, he is able to understand that if you take away the upadhis, then there cannot be any difference in the shuddha chaitanya. Kintu shuddham chaitanya matram bhaseta tasmat stula upadhi sahita viradatmaka vishvaha akara vachyartha. So vachyartha he has landed on, which has taken the upadhi of the stula and sukshma shariras. Sukshma shariras, I'm saying because I'm covering the later also. Sukshma, the second point also. Here only vyashti and samashti upadhis being the vachyartha akara of omkara. But the bheda of vyashti and samashti is also due to only upadhi bheda, stula drishtya. Similarly, sukshma drishtya. Tatha eva sukshma upadhi sahita hiranya garvatmaka taijasa ukara vachyartha. Samashti sukshma upadhi drishtya shuddha chaitanya hiranya garvatvam vyashti sukshma upadhi drishtya taijasvatvam cha abhat. So it's taijasvatvam and hiranya garvatvam is due to the upadhi veda at the vyashti and samashti respectively. Sukshma upadhi drishti virahetu. Once that sukshma upadhi perspective goes away, tadatmya sambandha can be dropped. The identification won't be there anymore because it is just the upadhi, like the redness of the flower on the crystal. Kintu shuddham chaitanya matram bhaseta. And similarly with the karana sharira. So I'll just quickly go through. Tathaiva karana upadhi sahita ishvaratma prajnya makara vachyartha samashti ajnana upadhi drishtya shuddha chaitanya ishvaratvam abhat. Vyashti jnana upadhi drishtya prajnyatvam abhat. So samashti ajnana is the upadhi for Brahma, who is called as Ishvara, and the same shuddha chaitanya Brahma is called as prajnya when he has vyashti ajnana upadhi as upadhi. Ajnana upadhi drishti virahetu. Once you take away this ajnana, whether you call it as maya at samashti level or avidya at the individual level, when it goes away, cognitively if you look at it, then ajnana upadhi drishti virahetu ishvaratvam prajnyatvam va na bhasyeta kintu kevala chaitanya matram pratiyeta. Now this is what he has gathered in brahmaloka. Kincha yatra yadvastu anya drishtya pratiyate tatra tadvastu paramarthata nasti. This much he was somehow able to gather even in the manushya janma, but he was not able to hold on to it. One, or jnana itself was not so clear. But in the brahmaloka it is clear, and then he is able to not only think up to this point, but he is able to go further and understand the vyapti also. Yatra yadvastu anyadrishtya pratiyate. Wherever you see some vastu appearing differently, there is a pratiti matra. That pratiti matra does not have any satta of its own. So paramarthata tadvastu nasti. Pratiyamanaha pratiyamanam vastu nasti. So its satta is what? Adhishtana satta matra. Yasya vastunaha yad rupam anya drishtim vina svataha eva pratiyate tadeva tasya paramarthikam rupam swarupam. So what I said is yasya vastunaha, in contrast, whichever vastu yad rupam anya drishtim vina svataha eva pratiyate, without any other drishti, in any which way you look at it, there is no other drishti possible, there is no other perspective. From any perspective, it looks like the same vastu. This is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara has said in the Bhashya. As that yad vastu na vyabhicharati. Yad vyabhicharati, the way the vastu has been cognized. Yena rupena. In Prathamakshana, if you look at, take a Prathamakshana, if you take, so in whichever way there is pratiti, that never undergoes vyabhichara. Yanna vyabhicharati tad satyam, yad vyabhicharati tad mithya. So yasya vastuna yad rupam anya drishtim vina svataha eva pratiyate. Satta is also its own, and there is no vyabhichara also. Always looks the same. So that is Trikala Vaditam Sat Tadeva Tasya Paramarthikam Rupam Swarupam. So that is its own Swarupa Paramarthika. It is the real nature. There is nothing superimposed there. Yathakin Kasminchit Purushe Pitradrishtya Putratvam Pitamahadrishtya Pautratvam Cha Pratiyamanam Natasya Paramartha Dharma Kintu Purushattvam Eva Tasya Paramartha Dharma. So if you look at a person, if you have a drishti of Pita. So if you look at from the perspective of the father, the person appears as Putra. If you look at it from the perspective of the grandfather, the same person looks like Pautra, grandson. That is not his Paramartha Dharma. But from both the perspectives, does he or does he not look like a person? Definitely looks like a person. So the same person looks like it is given another name. So that name is not his Paramartha Swarupa. He is neither the son nor the grandson only. So we should not say he is not that at all. He has not become that. He has got a name tag. So he is not limited to being the Putra or the Pautra. He is a human being first, Purusha. So Purushattvam is his Paramartha Swarupa there. Kintu Purushattvam eva tasya Paramartha Dharmaha. Now, this is obviously not from the Paramarthika Drishti. We are talking about Vyavaharika. So, example has to be extended in the Paramarthika Drishti. Tatha, Stula Sushma Karanopadi Drishtya, Bhasamana Vishwatva, Taijasatva, Prajnyatva. So, Tatha, Stula Sushma Karanopadi Drishtya, Bhasamana Vishwatva, Taijasatva, Prajnyatvadayaha, na Paramartha Dharmaha, Parantu, Mithyayavate. So, you extend it to the Shariras, all the three Shariras. All the upadis are mithya, but Chaitanya Matram Paramartha Satyam. Wherever you look at, from whichever perspective you look at, the same Vishwatajasa and Prajna, the names that you are given, they are all Chaitanya. Therefore, Paramartha Satya is Chaitanya Matram. Tatcha Chaitanyam Samastha Bheda Shunyam Virajaha Vishwasya Bheda Upadika Eva. So, Tatcha Chaitanyam, that Chaitanya is without any bheda. Nama bheda is not really bheda. It is not going to change anything. You call a rose by any other name, it is still a rose. Meaning it will have the same characteristics of the rose. So Rupa does not change at all. Virajaha Vishwasya cha bheda upadika eva. Upadikrata bhedas between the samashti and vyashti. Tayo rubhayo stula upadikatve api samashti upadikaha virat. So even if both have stula upadis, one has samashti upadi, whereas vishvastu vyashti upadikaha. We know all this, so it is a sum up. In fact, I forgot that there is one more avarta to be covered. So I thought we have to start from 215. So tachya chaitanya takes the samashti and vyashti stula upadi, and similarly the sukshma samashti and vyashti upadis, and so on. So bheda, if you look at it, where is it? Upadi krita bheda, but swarupata bhedo nasti. So samashti vyashti upadi prayukta bheda tve api virad vishvayoho swarupata nasti bheda, swarupa bheda isn't there. Tathaiva hiranyagarbha taijasayoho samashti vyashti upadi prayukta bheda vatve api. Even if this samashti and vyashti bhedas are there in the sukshma sharira also, and therefore Hiranyagarbha and Taijasa have differences, but Swarupata there is no bheda. Evam eva Ishvara Prajnayoho samashti vyashti upadhi nibandana eva bheda na swarupam. So nibandana is hetu, karana. So samashti vyashti is a karana for which bheda. That bheda is not going to change the swarupa. Ittham cha prajnya Ishvarasya taijasena Hiranyagarbhasya Vishvena. So Prajnena Ishvarasya. Prajnena Ishvarasya Taijasena. There is a Prajnena Ishvarasya. Yeah, Prajnena Ithancha. So in this manner, when you look at the Bhedas as Mithya, Nama Rupas as Mithya, Swarupata there is no Bheda at any level, then Ithancha Prajna, Prajnena Ishvarasya Taijasena Hiranyagarbhasya Vishvena Virajahacha Abheda Siddha. This is how Abheda is established, which is what should have been possible here and now, but this person understands it in Brahmaloka. Evameva stulopadikasya sukshmopadikena va karanopadikena va na bheda gandhopyasti. So there is not even a whiff of bheda in Vyashti and Samashti, because Chaitanya is the Swarupa of both at all levels. Yataha stula sukshma karanopadi drishti parityage Chaitanya Swarupena kopi bhedosti. Therefore, Swarupata bheda nasti kincha anatmanah sakashad api Chaitanyasya nasti bhedaha. Now, what about anatma? Is anatma different from atma? Yes, because we have been taught, so this is the first step. Viveka, Vairagya, Shamadhi, Shatka, Sampatti, and then Mukshutvam. This is what makes a person a sadhaka, an adhikari. So, Atma is definitely separated from Anatma. But Anatma, does it have its existence at all? Kincha Anatmana Sakasharapi Chaitanyasya Nasti Bheda. Just give me a moment, there's some noise. So Chaitanya is not really different from Anatma, because to say that something is different, it should have its own reality first. Yataha Anatma Bhuta Dehadi Prapanchaha Avidyadashayameva Bhati Na Paramarthataha. They are seen to have their own reality. The world is seen as an existent world only when there is avidya. Paramarthataha, we don't see that a world exists separately. Tasmad anatma prapanchasya api chaitanyena saha abhedaha asangata eva. Therefore, entire anatma prapancha, jagat, jada, is not separate from chaitanya. It cannot be different at all because it is not present. Itham sarva bheda shunya asanga nirvikara nitya mukta parabrahma swarupa pratyagatma ओंकार लक्षार्थत्वेन स्वयं प्रकाशतया ब्रह्मलोके उपासकस्य भासते. सो फॉर दिस उपासक नाउ इट इज वेरी क्लियर इन ब्रह्मलोक, बिकॉज़ द सेल्फ शाइनिंग नेचर ऑफ ओंकार लक्षार्थ विच इज तुरीयात्मा विच इज परब्रह्म इज नॉट हिडन एनी मोर एज मच एज इट वॉज हिडन अर्लियर. देर आर नो ऑब्स्टैकल्स देयर बिकॉज सत्व ऑलमोस्ट only sattva is there, sattva guna. Therefore, this sarvabheda shunya, sarvabheda includes the atma anatma also, not only vyashti samashti bheda, not only stula sukshma and karana bheda at vyashti and samashti levels, not only avastatraya bheda but also anatma atma bheda goes away because anatma is mithya. Because when you said that stula sharira abhimani virat is vishwa, and then vishwa is collapsed into tejasa and so on, that time you already made all this anatma, because the sharira of virat, sharira of vishwa is anatma. There is no other anatma there. But then still, other than these sentient beings claiming the jada prapancha part as one's own sharira, there is something insentient out there. That is also included here when you say anatma is one with atma. Thereby, once he gets this knowledge, this upasaka is no longer an upasaka, he is a jnani. Tasmad hiranyagarbhaloke vasataha upasakasyana puna samsara gatihi. Then he is a jnani, therefore there is no samsaranam. किंतु सज्ञानेन विदेह कैवल्यमेव आपनोति कार्य ब्रह्मण अवसान समये. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट ही अटेन्स विदेह कैवल्यम, विदेह मुक्ति, व्हेन दी कार्य ब्रह्म इज रिजॉल्वड प्रलय सम प्रलय काले इत्यर्थ. ओंकारस्य महावाक्यानां च अर्थैकत्वम. सो महावाक्यास टीच दिस ऐक्य. सो ओंकार इज ऑल्सो टू बी अंडरस्टूड इन दिस मैनर. यद्यपि महावाक्य विवेकमंतरा ज्ञानम न सिद्ध्यति इति सिद्धांतः विदाउट महावाक्य देर कैन नॉट बी ज्ञान. हाउ डिड दिस उपासक गेट ज्ञान फ्रॉम ओंकार. महावाक्य इज नॉट लिमिटेड टू दीज फोर. महावाक्य इज वेर एवर यू गेट ऐक्य बिटवीन ईश्वर एंड जीवा, दैट जीवा बीइंग मी. तथापि ओंकार विवेकस्य महावाक्य विवेक रूपत्वाद् ओंकार विवेकेनापि ज्ञानम् उदीयाद् एव. जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट, आई वांट टू सी इफ आई कैन फिनिश दिस. जस्ट लेट मी टेक अ मोमेंट. Sorry, I just pushed my other class by 15 minutes so that I can, you know, finish this if possible, so we can end this chapter. So, kintu sa jnanena videhe kaivalyam eva apnoti. So, this was said there. Kaivalya, how does he get kaivalya without the mahavakya? Here, mahavakya, we have seen vachyartha of akara, ukara, makara, but what is the laksharta? That laksharta is parabrahma. So aikya jnana is possible even with omkara, analyzing omkara the way it is described earlier. Sorry. So tathapi omkara vivekasya mahavakya viveka rupatvad. Omkara viveka is also similar to mahavakya viveka, because mahavakya viveka leads to aikya. It is an analysis of aikya, vachyartha and lakshartha. This vachyartha lakshartha is there in omkara also. Vyashti samashti differences are, we have seen in using omkara also. The same omkara is having akara, ukara, makara, which can be seen at a vyashti level as well as samashti level. Thereby you can land on vyashti samashti aikya using akara, ukara, makara as tools. Therefore, they have similarity to analysis of mahavakya. Therefore, omkara vivekena api jnanam udiyadeva. Therefore, jnana can be possible, jnanotpatti is possible due to omkara viveka also. Tatha hi stula upadhi sahita chetana akara vachyartha. Stula upadhi rahitaka rahita kevala chetana. Sorry. So stula upadhi sahita chetana and stula upadhi rahita kevala chetana. This is how we can do vachyartha and lakshartha analysis with omkara also, because akara vachyartha is stula upadhi sahita chetana, whether at vyashti or samashti level. And stula upadhi rahita kevala chetana is akara lakshartha. Again, lakshartha, when you say whether it is lakshartha of vyashti or samashti, you will land on the same chetana. Therefore, vachyartha and lakshartha difference is there even in omkara vichara. Sukshma upadhi sahita chetana ukara vachyartha, sukshma upadhi rahita chetana ukara lakshartha. Karana upadhi sahita chetana makara vachyartha, karana upadhi rahita chetana makara lakshartha. So lakshartha at all levels is the same chetana which does not have any upadhi, इत्थम उपाधि सहित विश्वादय अकारादि मात्रण वाच्यार्थ एंड उपाधि रहित केवलम चेतन सकल सकल मात्राण लक्ष्यार्थ दि लक्ष्यार्थ ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी मात्रा इज द सेम तुरीय आत्मा शुद्ध चैतन्य वेर एज उपाधि सहित मीनिंग्स डिफर एट द अदर मात्र लेवल्स अकार उकार मकार तथा एव नाम रूपात्मक अखिल उपाधि सहित चेतन ओंकार आख्य वाच्यार्थ सो व्हाट इज द एंटायर वाच्यार्थ ऑफ द एंटायर ओंकार अकार उकार मकार पुट टुगेदर अमात्र इज देयर व्हिच इज नॉट हर्ड देयरफॉर वी डू नॉट नो ओंकार शब्द एज हैविंग अमात्र व्हिच इज इक्वेटेड टू चैतन्य वी ओनली सी अकार उकार एंड मकार We look at Vyakrana there, Akara, Okara, together is Okara, there is Guna Sandhi. Makara is a Vyanjana, Halanta Shabda. So we'll say Om. Om is an Avyaya. Shastra, Vyakrana Shastra tells us Om is an Avyaya. Then Vedas tell us that Omkara has an Uccharana. It is Plutha. Vyakrana also tells us it is Plutha. So Rasva Dirga Plutha. So it is Trimatrika. There are three matras consumed when you pronounce Omkara. And then in some upasanas, it can go up to, in some chantings, it can go up to 12 matras. This much we know about Omkara. So what is the vachyartha of the entire Omkara? It is Ishvara really. So Omkara vachyartha is what? Nama rupatmaka akhila upadhi sahita chetana. This chetana, which is along with the entire Nama Rupa Atma Akhila Prapancha really. That is Omkara Vachyartha because Chetana is hidden as the Amatra. So individual level there is Vachyartha and Lakshyartha difference. At the total level of Akara Okara Makara, Om, individual and total in the sense, not the Vyashti Samashti, but I am saying the individual Akshara and the Shabda. Between Akshara and Shabda, if you look at it, Akshara also has Vachyartha Lakshyartha Bheda and Omkara Shabda also has Vachyartha Lakshyartha Bheda. So when you look at Vachyartha complete, then Omkara stands for the entire Nama Rupatmaka Akhila Upadhi Sahita Chetana. Nama Rupatmaka Sakala Upadhi Rahita Kevala Chetana is Omkara's Lakshartha. Ittam Omkarasya Mahavakyanam Cha Artha Eka Eva Bhavati. There is only one Artha, just like Mahavakya also gives you this Lakshartha with Bhagatyaga Lakshana. In Omkara also you can do Bhagatyaga, Jadajal Lakshana and land on the same goal. Therefore, Eka Eva Artha Bhavati. तस्माद् ओंकार विवेकेन एव अद्वैत आत्मज्ञानं जायते इत्थम् अदृष्टि आचार्य वाक्यं श्रुत्वा उपासनायां प्रवृत्तः ज्ञानद्वारा परमपुरुषार्थ मोक्षं अलभत एंड इन दिस मैनर माइंड यू अदृष्टि इज नॉट अ सन्यासी एंड दिस उपासना वाज टॉट टू अ सन्यासी हाउ डिड अदृष्टि गेट ज्ञान फ्रॉम दिस Because he did not do upasana. He understood the way it is taught. If he couldn't understand it and then he had to do dhyana, he would have had to take sannyasa and then Brahmaloka would have been his gati if he had not got jnana in that janma. But here what is said, he got jnana there itself because the guru is teaching on bhuloka. So ittham adrishti acharya vakyam shrutva upasanayam pravruttaha jnana dvara. So, Jnana Dwara Parama Purushartha Moksham Alabhata. Or you have to understand that he has given up everything and then he has become a sannyasi because Upasanayam Pravruttaha has been mentioned. So you have to assume that after listening to this, the Acharya gave him sannyasi diksha and then Jnana Dwara Parama Purushartha Moksham Alabhata because he did Upasana, it made the Chitta Shuddha and whatever was taught in the end, here in the 214, he was able to do and therefore he got Parama Purushartha, which is Moksha. Nirguna Upasana Adhikarina Kartavyam. So Nirguna Upasana Adhikarina Kartavyam. So this Nirguna upasana anadhikarina kartavyam. So one who is not a nirguna upasana adhikari, sannyasi. So here, so we can assume that adrishti took sannyasa. So nirguna upasana anadhikari. Who is an anadhikari? Not a sannyasi. Because especially with omkara, nirguna upasana can be done by others also, but specifically with omkara it should not be done. Because omkara adhikara, the omkara adhikara is kevala omkara adhikara is for a sannyasi. So yaha nirguna upasane anadhikari, one who is not an adhikari in nirguna upasana. And who is that? That is mentioned here. So in the tippana, vedanta shravana manana rupa vichare pravruttaha jijnyasu tam vihaya na anyat sadhanam anutishthet. So one who is engaged in vedanta shravana manana rupa vichara, shravana is also vicharatmaka, manana is also vicharatmaka. Because when you are listening, it should not be Shuddha Shravana. Shuddha Shravana means, you know, just hearing. Shravana is Vicharatmaka. When the teaching is going on, their inquiry should be there. The question should come up. They should get resolved in Manana. So Shravana should facilitate inquiry at the same time. Therefore, that Jijnyasuhu, Jnatumichuhu, Tam Vihaya Na Anyat Sadhanam Anutishtet. That kind of a person, Sadhaka, Jnana Adhikari, should not do any other sadhana. He should give up all sadhanas. Vedanta vichara shilaha purushaha yadi vicharam parityajya anyatra prasajyate sa arunha patito bhavati. So they will fall from a good height if the person who is has taken to Vedanta vichara, which is the last step really. From there he will have a steep fall if he gives up that vichara and does everything else. Athava karastam madhu santajya kurparam lady madhu moodadhihi iti nyayasya vishayo bhavati. So there is a tease, there is a nyaya, which is somebody has a honey in his hand, but instead of licking that honey, what is he licking? He is trying to lick his elbow. A normal person, normally a person cannot lick one's elbow. Why is he trying to lick the elbow? Because he is working with the bees, or he is trying to extract the honey from the forest area wherever, or he is bringing it, in whichever manner you can understand. There is honey all over his hands, not only in his palm, but there is honey. There is some honey on the elbows also. No, giving up the honey which is there in the, which is easily accessible. This fellow wants to access the honey on the elbow tip. Cannot lick it. This is our pursuit of Vishaya Ananda. Vishaya Sukha we can never get. Easily we can get the Atma Sukha if you drop every other pursuit. Drop. Of course, it's a tall order. You cannot just give up everything easily. But it is, it should be as easy. As easy as what you already are and not pursuing. The pain is to try to lick the elbow instead of licking the hand. Instead of giving up everything and having Swarupa Ananda, we are trying to hanker after Vishaya Sukha, which we never get. It is never Nitya. But still the pursuit is, a pain is there due to the search. If you call off the search, the pain won't be there. The goal will be achieved. It is as simple as that. It should be as simple as that. But it is laughable that we are following the Vishayas Janma Janma Antara, not in one Janma. Every time we are pursuing something as though we are trying to lick our elbow, which is never going to be possible. So that is it is here. Athava karastam madhu santyajya kurparam ledhi madhudhihi. Well, sorry, moodadhi. Madhu is there, so the madhu is stuck in the mind. So ananda is always stuck in the mind. So moodadhi, one who has moodadhi yasya, sa moodadhi, a dullard, lady licks what? Kurparam. Licks, tries to lick the elbow. Having given up santyajya karastam madhu, the honey which is right there in his palm. Iti nyayasya vishayo bhavati. This person will be subject to that tease. Yaha karastam madhu pramadat parisravya madhuna liptam kurparam ledhi paschat तस्य तुल्यो भवति वेदांत विचारं परित्यज्य अन्यत्र प्रसक्त पुरुषः. सो हैविंग कम टू वेदांत विचार वन नोज दैट इन वेदांत श्रवण वन नोज दैट वन स्वरूप इज आनंद स्वरूप. Nowhere else this ananda is there. It is the same ananda which is manifesting. Why would one still hanker after that? Tasmad vedanta vichara shila purushaha sudruda bodhodaya paryantam vicharameva kuryat. Should not do anything else. That is why sannyasa. Because one cannot stay at home and not do anything else. One has so many things to do. Laukika vaidika both. But here the vishaya is vaidika. Vaidika responsibilities are there. And today, Laukika responsibilities are so overwhelming. One has thrown upon oneself so many responsibilities that one cannot give up anything else for a moment. Therefore, one takes time off to do Vedanta Vichara. One class in the morning, you know, is sufficient. We all feel so. Unfortunately, it is not sufficient. Vedanta Vichara is not limited to one class. Like Swami Paramarthananji says, Vedanta Vichara, offline classes, is Simita, only to Jnana is limited to the class. As soon as one wears one's footwear, Jnana is gone. Online classes, same thing, you know, switch off and then the Jnana goes away. That shouldn't be the case, therefore Sannyasa is prescribed. Yasya Vichare na Pravruttir Bhavati sa Nirguna Upasanam Kuryat. When Pravritti is not possible here, then Nirguna Upasana should be followed. Tatraya Shaktena Upavasat Varabhiksha Iti Nyayana Saguna Upasanadikam Kartavyam Bhavet. Ashaktena. So now one who has eligibility in Vedanta Vichara, one who can do Vedanta Vichara, who gives up Vedanta Vichara and does something else, he is a Mudadhi. But one who is a mumukshu, jijnyasu, who does not do any other activities but keeps only to Vedanta Vichara, he will get jnana. So he should do vicharameva kuryat. He should do only vichara, nothing else. Should not do any other karma, upasana. He should take to, actually sannyasa eva adhikara. Why? Because karmani adhikara eva nasti. Once one knows that I am akarta, abhokta, atma, then where is the adhikara in karma? Karma is with the raga desha in mind. Whether or not one agrees, there is some swartha, some goal to achieve. That goal is already achieved in jnana because one is an akarta now. So what will he do? There to do anything, there has to be bheda also. Abheda is there. He is an akarta. At least he is an akarta. As soon as you think that you are an akarta, every pursuit should drop. But it doesn't drop. Then what should one do? Jnana is not there. Therefore, one should take to upasana. Which upasana? Nirguna upasana. If nirguna upasana is also not possible. So, tatrai ashaktena. One who has no possibility of understanding this upasana also and who cannot take sannyasa also, then what should one do? Upavasat varabhiksha iti nyayena. Instead of starving, go for bhiksha. So iti nyayena saguna upasana adhikam karti. So nirguna upasana I can't do. I don't understand jnana also. Then what should I do? Let me go back to my earlier lifestyle of continuing in samsara. Instead of that kind of an upavasa of starving yourself of moksha, bhiksha vara. So go to saguna upasana. At least do that. So that is the meaning of yaha nirguna upasane anadhikari. One who cannot understand jnana, one cannot do nirguna upasana, he should continue to do saguna upasana. Sa sagunam ishwaram sada manasi dharayat. What is saguna upasana there? Who is saguna? Maya vishishta chaitanya rupam karanam brahma saguneshwara iti uchyate. So maya vishishta chaitanya, saguna. And the saguna ishwara, it can be in any form also. Athava karana brahma upalakshana bhuta hiranyagarbha vaishvanara hiranya Hari Hara Gauri Ganesha Arkadayaha Karya Brahma Rupa Api Saguneshwaratvena Dhyeya. So either you understand someone without any Rupa particularly, Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, if you can hold on to that subtlety, then that is Saguneshwara. Or you take the Karana Brahma Upalakshana Bhuta with Nama Rupa, whether Hiranyagarbha, Vaishwanara, हरि हर स शिव विष्णु इत्यादि गौरी गणेश अर्क सूर्य इत्यादि कार्य ब्रह्म रूपापि सगुणेश्वरत्वेन ध्येयाः अथवा और तेषां हरिहरादीनां प्रतीकभूत सालग्रामादयः तेषां प्रतिमा विशेषाश्च सगुणेश्वत्वेन उपास्याः सगुण ईशत्वेन सगुणेशत्वेन उपास्याः व्हाट आर दोस प्रतिमा विशेषाः whether you take the murtis so murti also can be seen as that ishwara itself not as limited to one nama roopa whether it is salagrama or anything else any idol purvokteshu upasyeshu uttarottara apekshaya purva purvasya upasanam prashastam bhavati so the more you come to form the more form is there because if you take a murti instead of that take salagrama which has no particular form it is has lesser form and if you can go even subtler then go to ahangra upasana so the more subtler the upasana the more closer it is to reality the way it is which is without nama rupa so it is prashasta it is better it is shreshta uttaratra saptama tarange vakshamana kramena maya vishishta chaitanya rupam karanam brahma ishvara shabdasya mukhyartha tadeva upasyam So this Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Rupa, which will be talked in Prathama Saptama Tarange Vakshyamana Kramena. In seventh chapter, this will be taken up. That is the Ishvara Shabdasya Mukhyartaha, which is Maya Vishishta Chaitanya. Karana. Tadeva Upasyam Tathapi Mayantu Prakritim Vidyan Mayinamtu Maheshwaram Iti Shrutya. Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Anyasya Vastunaha Abhava Shri Vidyaranya Swamina Sarva Mata Virodhena चित्र दीपे ईश्वर स्वरूपम अवर्णयन सो भगवान विद्यारण्याचार्य हैज टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस इन पंचदशी ऑल्दो द मुख्यार्थ ऑफ ईश्वर इज कारण स्टिल ही सेड मायां तु प्रकृतिं विद्यात् मायिनं तु महेश्वरम सो वन हु वील्ड्स माया इज महेश्वर इति श्रुत्या माया विशिष्ट चैतन्यात् अन्यस्य वस्तुना अभावात् Since there is nothing other than Ishwara, this Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, therefore Ishwara Swarupa is mentioned, which cannot be opposed to any mata. So avirodhena, sarva mata avirodhena, Chitradipa chapter he has mentioned. Tadanusarena Hiranyagarbhadi sarvam upasya vastu Ishwara eva iti abhipraya. So Ishwara can be thought about it any form. The more you go to forms and names, the more away you are from the nirguna upasana that is why subtler the better you can go towards nirguna upasana and then jnana that is the idea finally saguna upasane ashaktah nishkamataya nitya naimittikani karmani anutishtan ishware samarpayet whereas one who is not eligible even in saguna upasana what should that person do he should do karma yoga so Nitya Nimittikani, not Kamya Karmas, one should do Varnashrama, prescribed karmas, and thereby offering it to, with Prasada Buddhi, taking whatever is offered, and first offering the karma itself to Ishwara. Karma Virama Kali Ishwarapi Bhajeta. And then one should do worship of Ishwara after the karma. Nishkama Karma Kartum Api Ashakta Sakamaha Shastrokta Shubha Karmani Anutishtet. If one is not able to do karma yoga, what should one do? I want phala. How can I give up phala? Nishkama one cannot be. Then, okay, be sakama. But do only the punya karma. Shastrokta shubha karmani anutishte. Do not do papa karma. Tatra api ashakta. Okay, I cannot do that also. Then what should one do? Tatra api ashakta. Yasa shataha punaf punar janma marana pravahe patati. Then you continue in samsara till you grow up to give up papa karma. Do punya karma, then the chitta shuddhi is sufficient enough to understand what is karma yoga, then you do karma yoga, then you can do saguna upasana, then you can do more and more subtle saguna upasana with salagrama ityadi, then you can do nirguna upasana, then you can, if you get jnana, well and good, you will get jivan mukti with shravana mananirisa, otherwise you can get krama mukti in the brahmaloka. So that is the process there थर्ड पॉइंट फलाभिसंधि मंत्रा स्वस्व वर्णाश्रमोचितानि कर्माणि केवलम ईश्वरार्पण बुद्धिया कुर्यात्। सो ईश्वरार्पण बुद्धि एंड देन प्रसाद बुद्धि आल्सो टेकिंग व्हाटएवर फला कम्स, इफ इट कम्स वेल एंड गुड, अदरवाइज आल्सो आई एम ओके, दैट इज कर्मयोग। बट स्वस्व वर्णाश्रम उचितानि कर्माणि, नॉट समबडी एल्सेस। व्हाई? परधर्मः भयावहः। परधर्म इज पापकारक, दैट इज वाई भयावह। द्वितीयाद्वयी भयं भवति, संसरणं विल कंटिन्यू। एट लीस्ट दैट मीन्स वी शुड नो दैट इफ यू डू समबडी एल्सेस वर्णाश्रम धर्म, इट विल ब्रिंग मोर भया, मीनिंग संसार विल कंटिन्यू। इफ यू वॉन्ट मोक्ष हियर एंड नाउ, देन यू हैव बॉर्न इन द राइट फैमिली, फॉलो दैट एंड देन चित्त शुद्धि विल बी ईजी, ज्ञानोत्पत्ति विल बी ईजी। कर्मोपर काले at the end of the karma namocharanaadi roopam ishvara bhajanam cha kuryat। So this we understand, phalechham vina anutishtam ishvare samarpitam cha vihitam karma ishvara prasad hetur bhavati, this will invoke grace of ishvara, ataha nishkama karma anushthanam ishvara bhajana roopam eva bhavati। Nishkama karma is same as ishvara bhajana, this is what is said that the Gita Shastra says that as swasva karmani nirataha in the 18th chapter says that I think some 46 or somewhere 45 swakarma nirata siddhim yatha vinditi tashrunu, but before that he says sve sve karmani abhirata samsiddhin labate naraha, and in the 46th verse यतः प्रवृत्तिर भूतानां येन सर्वमिदं ततम स्वकर्मणातम अभ्यर्च सिद्धिं विन्दति मानः। स्वकर्मण तम ईश्वरम अभ्यर्च, हैविंग डन अर्चना वर्शिप ऑफ दैट ईश्वर, हाउ? नॉट विथ मंगलारती एंड ऑल दैट, दैट इज ऑल राइट, बट दैट इज मूर्ति पूजा। यू लुक एट इट, यू लुक एट ए फॉर्म, दैट फॉर्मलेस ईश्वर इज बिहाइंड दैट मूर्ति, हाउ डू यू वर्शिप हिम? स्वकर्मण क्षत्रिय अर्जुन, दैट्स व्हाई अर्जुन वाज आस्क्ड टू फाइट द बैटल बिकॉज इट इज हिज धर्म, वर्णाश्रम धर्म, नॉट सिट इन द फॉरेस्ट एंड डू भजन इत्यादि, नॉट मंगल आरती। व्हाट इज ही सपोज टू डू? ही इज सपोज टू फाइट हिज बैटल, धार्मिक बैटल, दैट इज हिज धर्म, वर्णाश्रम धर्म, एंड देयर बाय दैट इटसेल्फ स्वकर्मण तम ईश्वरम अभ्यर्च संसिद्धिम सिद्धिम विंदति मानवः, दैट इज सेड हियर पैराफ्रेजियल as swakarmana, swasva varnashrama uchitani karmani kevalam ishvara arpana buddhya kuryat, karma uparma kale namocharanadi rupam ishvara bhajanam cha kuryat, phalechham vina anutishtatam ishvare samarpitam cha vihitam karma ishvara prasad hetur bhavati, that will definitely invoke the grace of ishvara, there will be chitta shuddhi, and then shravana will lead to manana, then nishtha, and then moksha, ataha nishkama karma anushthanam ishvara bhajana rupam eva bhavati। So nishkama karma is ishvara bhajana, there is no other ishvara bhajana which is shrestha, if one does everything and then does bhajana, it is belittling the goal also, the path also, and the ishvara ichcha also। So in the end, omkararartha vicharena krutartho bhudrishtikah, omkararartha vicharena krutartho bhudadrishtikah etat taranga patana sudrishtim kurute guruhu। So the guru sudrishtim kurute, sushtu drishtim, aikya drishti, how? Etat taranga patanat, by studying this chapter। Why so? Because by this chapter we have an example of adrishti, omkar artha vicharena krutartha, who became krutakritya, attained moksha by omkar artha vichara, not omkar upasana, but landing on the vichara through omkara upasana, abhud adrishtika। So adrishti is the name of the person, so we have an example of him in this, how to do omkara vichara, which is similar to mahavakya vichara, and thereby who is not an uttama adhikari, madhyama adhikari also can get moksha। Iti shri vasudeva brahmendra saraswati virachite madhyama adhikarinah साधन वर्णनम नाम पंचम पंचमह तरंगः। सो दिस इज दी फिफ्थ चैप्टर बेस्ड ऑन मध्यमाधिकारी, विच इज फोकस्ड टुवर्ड्स मध्यमाधिकारी, कॉल्ड एज साधन वर्णन। व्हाट इज दी sadhana for moksha, as taught by Nishchala Das ji and then the Swami also, Shri Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati. Sukanityam Saprakasham Vyapakam Namri Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddheer Drikyatva Nivalam Param Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Annam Attonyaditi Menishchitamati Shri. I'll see in the next part. I'm a little too late for the next part here. Namaste.
Namaste. Hari Om.